How custom do you want your app to be? I want my app to be very custom. And that is why in this video, I'm going to show you how we can use Softr and our amazing custom domains in order to make your app that much more individualized. I'm in Softr right now, and I can go into any of these different applications. And once I dive into one of them, on the left side over here, if we go to settings, we then can hover over to custom domain. Now, in this custom domain section, you'll see that you can add your domain below if you already have one. Otherwise, use websites like Namecheap, GoDaddy to buy one. And for more details on how to set up a custom domain, we do have documentation on this, but it's pretty simple and easy to do. So for example, if I were to put digitalnative.com and then add domain, we'd see on the side here that the custom domain would now show up as, if I copy this application link, digitalnative.com. And I'm using that example as this is the template that I'm in. But when it comes to this, now what you need to do is go into your admin console on your host dashboard and copy the following information. So you need to essentially get this value into, if you were to go to something like Google Domains, and go to your DNS, what you'd essentially do is you can manage your custom records and you can map the A value inside of Google Domains by managing your custom records on whatever account it would be in to paste in the data right there. And then when it comes to the CNAME, you would also put in digitalnative.com for the CNAME as well. Now, I'm not going to show you the data on this because it is something that's more personal, but I did want to showcase to you how you could, for example, do it. Because after you change this and press save, essentially what this would do is within a few hours after you press refresh, this would show as connected instead of not connected. And then once you press publish, you would actually have a website that would go to digitalnative.com or whatever custom domain that you'd be using. It is a pretty simple and easy to understand method. Any of the other platforms you've seen before, it's pretty much the same system where you just need to copy the type A value for the at host and then take that CNAME and drop it right into your domain manager as well. And then if you want to remove this domain, you can click on there and then it would remove it. And I'm curious, what domain are you trying to connect to Softr using our custom domains? And what do you think about this video on how to improve your Softr knowledge even more?